Welcome to Algebra 2, Quiz 43. All right, they are going to ask you to write something in an exponential form. And so what that means, since the IN is E, we're going to put E, and then this is the exponent, and it equals 56. So that's how you write that one. And then it says to write it in logarithmic form. So it's log, and this is your base, log 6, and then this is like that. So log of 90 base 6 equals x. All right, and then they're going to have equations like this in which they want you to solve for x. Well, if we get these both to have the same base, then we can put the exponents together. Well, this is 5 to the third cubed, in other words. So, since the bases are the same, x equals 3. All right, here we can get the bases the same here. So, it'd be 5 to the 5x equals 5 squared. Now, the exponents can equal each other. I'm going to go ahead and distribute it. Then I'm going to subtract 2x, so 3x equals 6, so x equals 2, because you divide that. Okay, let's go up here. So these we can't get all to the same base, so we're going to have to put in the logarithm. So this would be log 4, and when it's multiplied, you can add them, and your exponent comes out in front. So it's x log 6 equals 20, log 20, sorry. Okay, so we're trying to get x by itself, so the things that's bothering it is a log 4 and the log 6. So we're gonna move this because it's put together by addition, so we need to subtract from both sides. So when we subtract, we have x log 6 equals log 20 minus log 4. Now what's bothering it is a log 6. It's together by multiplication, so we divide. So x equals log 20 minus log 4 all over log 6. And when you put that in the calculator, you'll actually put this in and then divide by this. You get 0.8982. Okay, so let's look at this and see if we can get the same base. We actually can, because 3 to the 4th is 81. So, x equals 4. Now, we need to solve for x for both 7 and 8. So, here is an x and here is an x. So, let's get all the x's to one side. So, since they are being subtracted, we're going to add it to both sides. Okay, in logarithm, if it's being added, you can multiply them. So let's do that. So the log of x plus 4 times 2x minus 2 equals 2. Now, we don't have a log over here, but we do here. So let's get rid of the log. And how we get rid of that, this one will drop off, but this is the same thing as 10 squared, because if the base is, if it's not written, it's base 10. So this will become the exponent. So 10 squared. All right, so let's FOIL this. That's 2x squared minus 2 plus 8, which would be plus 6x minus 8 equals 100. Now, we have a GCF of 2, so let's take 2 out. Okay, now this can kind of drop off because 2, when we set it equal to 0, 2 equals 0, so that doesn't work. So that can kind of drop off. So now we need to subtract 50 from both sides. So x squared plus 3x minus 54 equals 0. Then we factor it. And that would be 9 times 6. They will subtract, and that largest will have that. So when you set it equal to 0, x equals negative 9, or x equals 6. Because this is a negative number, it won't work, so we have that. All right, let's try this one. Okay, we have an x here and an x there. We want to get both x's to the same side. They're being added, so we're going to subtract. All right, just like in addition, it's multiplication. In subtraction, it will be division. We want to get rid of the logs, just like here. When we got rid of this one, the number became the exponent. Here, the number is going to become the exponent. Okay, now we want to get rid of this x, so we're going to multiply both sides by x, and we'll go ahead and get rid of that exponent because 10 to the first power is 10. So that would be x plus 2 equals 10x. Now, what's bothering, there's two x's on both sides, so we'll bring this over. So that's 9x. We divide by 9, so 2 ninths equals x. And that is 0.0333, 222. Okay, I hope you took good notes on this and that you're ready for the quiz. Good luck.